Next week, Richard Gere, Kim Basinger, and that man with a winning smile. David Letterman, next week on Today.
The Happy Network.
From always gorgeous and exciting San Antonio, Texas, where something is always happening good, back to Katie in New York.
Thanks, Willard. Love the sound effects. Thanks.
Thank you.
It's hard to believe that David Letterman has been answering viewer mail and presenting the latest in stupid pet tricks for 10 years now on his late night program. To begin our observance of this important milestone, Dave made the trip three flights down to our studio for some coffee and a little chat about his big primetime anniversary show, which airs tomorrow night here on NBC.
It's the David Letterman interview, featuring startling revelations from 10 years of late night, gravity-defying dogs, and some low-cal cooking tips for better health. And now, from Studio 3B in New York's famed GE building, it's Katie and David Letterman.
10 years, a decade of late night with David Letterman. Does it feel like 10 years?
I'll tell you why. In one word, why we've been on the air 10 years. In one word, Johnny Carson. Actually, that's two words. But that would be the reason.
Explain.
Well, as I've pointed out, I think that when we went on the air in February of 1982, we followed The Tonight Show. And it's on, as you know, from 11:30 to 12:30, and then it would be us. And I think, especially in those days, you could put squirrels mating in a cage, and they would get about
you
the
have,
same.
You have, haven't you?
so you've seen the tapes. I think you would get about the same audience. Maybe the demographics would be a bit different, but I think in terms of pure numbers, they would be about the same as we have been able to generate.
Oh, come on.
All right.
Obviously, you're not putting on squirrels mating. You're doing a lot of different kinds of things. What do you look for when you put together a show every night?
We like the show to be, meet the press is really what we're after. If we can do like a 12:30 version of meet the press, then we say to ourselves, yes, yes, another job well done.
We're going to finish our chicken here. The
truffles sauces are expensive, ain't they?
It's very expensive. It costs like $600 a pound.
Wow.
And you know, everybody asks me what they smell like. I always tell them it smells like sex to me. You just try to smell them?
Jeez, what have you been doing?
Actually, in Austria, they pronounce it Schwarzenegger.
Schwarzenegger.
Yeah, so just to confuse you a little bit.
Yeah. Does the name mean something?
It means black plowman.
Black plowman?
Plowman, yeah. Wow.
Tell me about the wedding and your relationship with the Kennedy family.
What do you want to know?
Well, now, well, how do they feel about having a black plowman in the group?
Hey, I'm going to enjoy a beverage now, if you don't mind.
No problem. In our lovely Today at 40 mug. Did you know it's the Today Show's 40th anniversary?
No, really?
Like I've been in a trunk in a rental car at LaGuardia. No, I had no idea. Oh, and I see it's in color now, too. Wow.
That's right. Isn't this lovely?
No, but see, there you go. Talking about relative terms of success, 10 years seems meager, seems like no accomplishment whatsoever. It seems like a trifle when you compare it to a show that's been on the air long enough to have their own coffee mugs.
That's right. Pretty impressive,
yeah,
huh?
There's a breakthrough.
I understand that you make fun of this revered historic institution known as the Today Show.
Yeah, I've made fun of the show. This is one of my favorite things about being on the air this long, to have this kind of an association. We share crew members, our show and the Today Show, and one of the shared crew members had overheard a conversation where Bryant was supposed to have said, I'm going to go up there and just hit him.
Not our Bryant.
Yeah, yeah. And it was because they had this primetime version of the Today Show, and the producer in those days, who I don't remember his name,
Steve Friedman.
That's right. He came to us and he said, we're going to do this primetime show, and he said, between you and I, it's sort of going to be dull and plodding. So we need some heat. We need something to pep it up. We need to stir up. We need a little controversy. Can you do something? And we said, sure. We'll try and interrupt the show. We'll scream at Bryant with a bullhorn.
See what we can do. Go ahead, Carl. Take a look out there.
Attention. Attention, people of New York City. My name is Lawrence Grossman, the president of NBC News. This primetime program was my idea, and I'm not wearing pants.
Nobody told Bryant, you know, Mr. Friedman, Mr. Big Shot, Mr. Vince McMahon of the World Wrestling Federation didn't mention that to Bryant. So it all comes as a surprise to him. And he was very angry, and I don't blame him. And for years and years and years, he wouldn't speak to me, and he was really, really quite upset.
But now you guys have kissed and made up.
Yeah, see, the thing of it is, I always regretted that because I like him, and I think he's one of a handful of people, and I think NBC is lucky enough to have most of these people who are really good communicators and pure broadcasters. And so I always respected him for that, and so I was never mad at him, but he always wanted to come up and just, you know, do some work on me. And then later we were able, I could take him. I don't think that was ever in question. Once again, I've forgotten the question.
May I borrow a Kleenex?
Oh, sure.
Not the one that you used.
Here.
Yes,
you
thank you. Thank you.
See,
thank you very much.
See, another one pops up.
Yeah, I'm
right
sorry.
After.
Yeah, my nose is a little bit runny this morning. I don't know why. You said when you were a young lad growing up in Indiana, you said, all I ever want to be is a talk show host. Is that for real or is that just according to your press release?
I mean, do you think that that's the case?
I would
hope not. When you're like
11
years old and mom wakes you up in the morning, Dave, what do you want to do when you're 40? Like to be a talk show host, mom.
It's amazing when you think of the people who are coming out with their own talk shows. I mean, Jane Whitney is a former NBC Central American correspondent.
I don't know Jane Whitney.
Whoopi Goldberg. Dennis Miller.
Sure.
I mean, we're being inundated with these gabfests. What do you think of all this?
The real reason is they're very cheap to produce.
I was going to say, isn't
very
it?
Very inexpensive. Very inexpensive to produce. And we do 4 shows a week for under $20. Just to give you a rough idea.
That's and the folks at GE,
a ballpark figure.
They're very proud of you, aren't they? In fact, you like to poke fun at those pinheads at GE for. Do you ever hear from any of them?
The only time I heard from them, and I always thought this was a really telling story, and I enjoyed it when it happened, and it kind of put me in shock for a bit, and it took me a couple of days to kind of ingest this information.
It wasn't a dry skin thing again, was it?
No. We had an anniversary party, and I don't know what year it was. It was, I don't know, 6, 7, I don't know, whatever the year was. And there was a party. And Jack Welch, the Mr. GE, the man who...
The big kahuna.
Yeah, the guy who invented the... He lived next door to Edison or something. Anyway, he comes running up to us at this party, me and my friends at work and so forth. And he's got this big, silly fruit basket, you know. And he comes running up and he shoves it into my arms and he says, keep making fun of us. We love it when you call us pinheads. I just thought, wow, what does this tell you? Here's some insight into the corporate world. And then I saw the other day where their gross revenue for 91 was $63 billion. $63 billion.
With a B.
So I guess if you're turning that kind of cash through a company, you don't care what people call you.
That's right.
Yeah.
So, Bryant, what do you think? You think you could take him or he could take
you? I don't
know.
We're probably in different weight classes.
Maybe. I like when he said NBC is lucky to have you, Bryant.
Dave,
what a brown noser. Sheesh. Tomorrow morning, Dave will be back to reveal the identity of the guest with the gravity-defying hair and what he thinks of the big to-do about Jay Leno getting the Tonight Show job. David Letterman is back this morning celebrating his big primetime 10th anniversary show tonight on NBC. He's conjured up some fond memories for us and some valuable insight into how this little TV experiment called Late Night with David Letterman has survived for the last 10 years.
It's the David Letterman Interview, featuring exclusive late-night interviewing techniques, personal hygiene of the stars, and some hairdo news you can use. And now, from Studio 3B in New York's famed GE building, it's Katie and David Letterman.
Morning, but all of that seems of little importance once you take a look at the cloud cover photograph made earlier of the United States today.
You started out as a local weatherman. Why did you do that?
What do you mean, why did I do that?
I mean, how did that opportunity present itself?
I was, again, really very lucky. I've been very lucky all my life as far as getting pretty cool jobs. And I was a junior in college, and a friend of mine's brother worked at this television station in Indianapolis. And he said, we're looking for a vacation announcer. Just come on down, and there's going to be like eight guys that are going to audition, and, you know, audition, and we'll see what happens. Well, not only did I audition, but I got the job, and so part of the duties of the vacation announcer, you would be the weekend weatherman and fill in various positions when folks were on vacation, and that's how I got the job.
Is that when it sort of became apparent that your real future was in comedy?
I'm not sure. I was so excited that, because in those days, it seemed like a miracle that you could be on radio or television. You know, this was like in the late 60s, and television hadn't been as accessible to lay people at that time, I don't think. It seemed like now anybody, so there's so much television, and if you really want to be on television, or even if you don't want to be on television, you can get yourself on.
Get into the fountain.
Get into it?
Come on, get in. If you get fired, I'll get you a job, honest. Just stand in the fountain. Come on over, just stand in there. Put the phone down, for God's sakes. All right, now just get in.
Okay.
Come on.
Yeah!
You felt at times that you was living in two worlds.
That's right. You know why? I was raised by poodles. That's the truth. Who are those women out there, by the way?
Neighbors.
I'll get rid of them. Hey. Excuse me.
Both you and Johnny Carson have had some fun with this whole controversy over the Jay Leno thing on The Tonight Show. Is that sort of behind you? A lot of people really do want to know, how ticked off were you when that happened?
I was never angry, really, about that. I was, you know, disappointed, obviously, but I was never angry. And it's interesting to me that somehow the story was that I was angry and that I was mad at The Tonight Show and mad at Carson and mad at Jay and on and on and on. But that aspect of it was so tiny in what was a bigger story. And it was just a matter of having worked for a network for a long time and things usually being great. And then suddenly, within the last year and a half or so, there were some problems, there was some trouble. And the Tonight Show just occupied, it was kind of another item on a list. Well, we had trouble with this, what's the deal there? We had trouble with that, what's the deal there? We had trouble with this. Oh, and then, by the way, now here's The Tonight Show. You guys just kind of drop by and casually mention this to us. So in and of itself, it was nothing that angered me.
Have you since made amends with the network executives here?
Well, I'm not sure I'm in the position to be making the amends.
Well, have they made amends?
Well, I will say that things are better now than they have been.
Yeah. You gonna stick around?
Well, I think I have another year left on my contract. And at that point, it will have been 11 years that we've been here. So we'll just see what things look like then.
Hmm. What about just a couple quick questions?
What do you mean,
questions?
Have I made amends?
Okay, excuse me for living. Have the two parties made amends, okay? You're reading a lot into that question, Dave.
I'm sorry.
All right.
You're very young, aren't you?
Depends. God, I look at myself up there and I look awful.
See, that's what I was talking about earlier.
Now, there are some who say that you are kind of mean-spirited and condescending.
That's crap. I don't know. I've heard this ever since we've gone on the air, and I don't know. I try to be as nice and as hospitable as I can.
Uh-huh.
And if there's going to be some sort of incendiary display, I'll usually wait for the other person to start. You know, I don't really. There's nothing premeditated about this. There's no malice involved here. We're not looking to be mean or hurtful or to get laugh.
You don't think you're funny at other people's expense sometimes?
Well, I didn't say that. Maybe we are funny at somebody else's expense, but I'm not sure that that's meanness. Mm-hmm. You know, I mean, you've been on the show. Was I mean to you?
No.
Do you know somebody I was specifically mean to?
No, but I remember when Natasha Kinski was on, and she had that hairdo that
right.
defied gravity.
Right.
You wouldn't talk about anything but her hairdo.
See, not true. We talked about many other things, and then she finally noticed her hair in the monitor, and she said, oh, I look like hell. And I just said, well, see, that's what I was trying to say. If somebody has, you know, like a grouper in her hair, and you don't... and you make a joke about it. And actually, I didn't really make a joke about it. I just said, you know,
what's that grouper in your hair?
No. I said, your hair is looks odd today. And she just said, well, you know, like I was too sophisticated to understand that it was cute to have a, you know.
Or avant-garde or something.
Yeah, yeah. But, you know, but if that's mean, I guess, you know, it's all in the perception.
Now, one guest has been on 62 times.
Oh, Lord. I haven't been on 62 times.
Marv Albert.
Oh, Marv Albert.
Now, he's a nice
guy.
He's got a great
grouper in his hair.
Why have you had Marv on so many times?
He's just great. He's entertaining. He's very likable. He brings on those wacky sports bloopers that we can't seem to get enough of those. And so that's why we have Marv on. And also, did I mention he's in the building?
Can you see doing this another 10 years?
I don't think so. I'm very surprised that we're here for 10 years. You know, on one hand, 10 years seems like, well, that's kind of an accomplishment. And then on the other hand, when you look at the Today Show or the Tonight Show, 30 years and 40 years, it doesn't really seem like we're even getting our feet wet yet.
Don't forget, Dave's Late Night Anniversary Show airs tonight at 9:30 on NBC. And Dave, I hope you're watching this morning because we have more of those zany sports stories coming up next. Not Marv Albert, this time Len Berman. But first, these messages.
Up next, as we continue for you on News 4 at 5, straight from the home office in Rockefeller Center, it is David Letterman. Al Roker talks to Big Dave about the 10th anniversary of his show.
David Letterman will be marking a very large anniversary on tonight's NBC special, 10 years. Yes, 10 years of Late Night with David Letterman. Al Roker heard all about it in his special talk with Dave, the Big Dave.
The Dave man, the Dave Meister. Well, Letterman was just 34 years old when Late Night first went on the air in 1982. So when Dave and I sat down to reminisce about the past decade, I actually found out he is still a little bit crazy after all these years.
You look awfully comfortable there, Dave.
Thank you very much, Al. May I have some more hors d'oeuvres, please?
You felt at times that you was living in two worlds.
That's right. You know why? I was raised by poodles.
When you look back at the last 10 years, what sticks out in your mind?
It's represented to me as kind of a smudge, blinding headache kind of feeling. It's kind of that smudge just before you wake up, before there's consciousness, but yet you are still perceiving external stimuli and that throbbing, white, hot, poker-like pain at the base of your skull.
So it's been fun.
Yeah.
Are you pleased with what you've done in the last 10 years?
You know what I'm really pleased with? Your appearances on the show.
Thank you.
Everybody in the building is talking about this thing, and yeah. We just thought maybe you could give us a tour of your new window.
No, that's it. Just take a look and get
this
out.
This is it?
When we were looking at those clips and we would see you, I don't know, it pepped everybody up. Ooh, I'm being overcome with a strange desire to kiss your forehead, Al. Please let me get through the interview without kissing Al's forehead.
When you started...
Oh my God. Woo! Bring me a damp cloth.
Once Dave composed himself, we started to talk a little more seriously. When you do this, you know, the anniversary shows, I mean...
It'll be our last one, by the way.
It is your last show?
Last anniversary show. We won't do another anniversary show. I don't care if we're on the air for 50 years, there will never be another anniversary show.
Dave says the pressures of producing the 10th anniversary special, while at the same time doing the nightly show, is just too much for him and his staff. And the job isn't getting any easier after 10 years. In fact, Letterman still can't tell if a show is going to be a winner until the audience is in their seats.
It's like when you're building an airplane. You know, test pilots will tell you, we don't know if this is an airplane until we're at the end of the runway and we rotate the stick. Gosh, I love that story.
I did.
I tell it as often as I can. And then, you know, so you get the show done and you put it in the editing and you kind of clean it up and tighten it up and do whatever you have to do. And then the next and the more important, the most important test is you put it on the air. And are people going to watch it instead of L.A. Law? I don't think so.
For folks who are going to, you know, need that extra push, reason to watch February 6th at 9:30, mm-hmm. Why should they be watching?
I'm naked and on fire.
Enough said.
Yeah, exactly.
There you go. Again, that's tonight here at Channel 4, 9:30. And after, if you want to stick around for News 4 at 11, right after the late night anniversary special, I'm going to show you another side of David Letterman, actually a fairly serious side. He talks about and gives us the real lowdown, what happened with the Jay Leno, the Tonight Show, NBC, GE thing, and it's kind of an interesting chat.
Did he happen to mention why he doesn't come over here anymore?
Well, because it's no longer live at 5. Oh. He said, you know, once that went away, he didn't think that he'd be welcome anymore because it was real news.
Oh, I see. I thought it had something to do with it. We locked both doors to the studio and I had Bob Hope with him.
He's got keys. What was also interesting in that I asked him, because there's been rumors that he's going to go out to Burbank, take the show out to Burbank. And in fact, he said, no, as long as he's working for NBC, he's doing it here. Now he's got a year to go on his contract, so I'll see what that means.
Well, that's good, because he's always fun.
You bet.
All right, Al, thank you. We'll look forward to that at 11. That's News 4 at 5. We thank you for watching. Do join us again tomorrow. Dawn and Chuck are up next. Hope you know, tonight David Letterman marked 10 years of Late Night with an anniversary special.
And our worker talked with Dave about the milestone and what lies ahead for him.
That's right. He actually got kind of serious, Chuck. Behind all the laughter from tonight's Late Night 10th anniversary special, there are some very serious questions about the future of the show and its host. In fact, the very future of David Letterman and his employer, NBC.
You're very young, aren't you?
Depends. God, I look at myself up there and I look awful.
See, that's what I was talking about earlier.
When you did first started 10 years ago, you pretty much had this thing to yourself. Now you got all these guys doing shows. Mm-hmm. How does that make you feel?
I wish I still had it to myself, frankly. It was a lot easier then. Yeah, there was nobody on when we started, and for a long time there was nobody on. And then everybody got their show. Arsenio got his show, and Pat Sajak had a show, and everybody else in between. And now it's, you know, who needs that?
Are you still, you know, psyched to do this? You know.
Well, as you know, it doesn't make any difference what you're doing on television, whether you're doing news, whether you're doing weather, whether you're doing the Sunday Today show. Whatever the format, if it's what you enjoy and what you love doing, it's always going to be a challenge and always going to be very exciting. We go into the studio every day at 5:30, and good or bad, each day, you have a chance to do the best you can.
Get into the fountain.
Get into it?
Come on, get in. If you get fired, I'll get you a job, honest. Just stand in the fountain. Come on over and just stand in there. Down, for God's sakes. All right, now
just get in. Okay. Come on. Yeah! Look, to put this thing to rest, as far as, you know, the Tonight Show thing, you know, I mean, what's the deal?
At the time they named it, NBC's picked Jay to be the host of the Tonight Show, there were many other things going on with us and our show on NBC. And many other things that I was truly angry about. The selection of Jay as the host for The Tonight Show didn't anger me, and it wasn't a surprise to me.
Here's Jay Leno!
There was several other things that the network was, we were involved in, that I felt angry about. And so The Tonight Show then, for me, became kind of another item on a list, and I felt like maybe we can use this to lever our way to get the balance of power a little more on our side of things. Mm. And of course, it failed miserably.
Well, Dave did clear up one rumor. He says he will not be moving the show to Los Angeles as long as he's working for NBC. But his contract with NBC runs out later this year. No one knows what will happen after that. He does also say that while there's been all these rumors about him going to ABC, that no one from that network has spoken with him or he with them.
Any indication as to what he was angry about, perhaps NBC selling his reruns to A&E?
He would not go into that, but that is rumored to be one of the things. But nice guy, and I hope, you know, he's here for a while longer.
Yeah,
well, we all do.
You betcha. Especially when we get on that show, we get paid for that. Anyway, let's take a look at what's going on outside. Right now, we mentioned some snow, and in fact, we've got the possibility of it again by tomorrow night.
Come on. Come on. Come on. And all
Thank you.
goes one-on-one with David Letterman on News 4 at 11.
Wings and L.A. Law return next Thursday with all new episodes. Now stay tuned for David Letterman's 10th anniversary special.
Believe me, I'm just as sick as you are about preempting L.A. Law.
From Radio City Music Hall in New York, New York, this must be prime time. It's the Late Night with David Letterman, 10th anniversary special. Featuring highlights from the past 10 years. Plus, stupid pet tricks. Bill Murray. Paul Schaefer with an all-star band. And special musical guest, Bob Dylan. And now, the newest star of L.A. Law, David Letterman.
For joining us. I'm Liza Minnelli. Thank you so much. This is our 10th anniversary special, and I don't care what happens from here on out tonight because I've spent the day with the Rockettes. You know, when you've been on the air for 10 years, you start to think about things, and it occurred to me earlier today, when we first went on the air here in New York City back in 1982, I believe the subway fare was 75 cents. 75 cents you could ride the subway, and now, 10 years later, it's a buck and a quarter. But that, of course, includes a continental breakfast, I think. haven't been on the subway for... I'm not sure. You know, NBC, of course, is owned and operated by General Electric. And that's right. Thank you. Why, you've taken the words right out of my mouth. If you think about the history of General Electric, this company has been unbelievably innovative. For example, it was General Electric that invented the self-cleaning oven. And I was talking to them a couple of days ago, and they tell me now that the boys in research and development are now working on a self-firing employee. So that was just, what a boon. Unbelievable how easy that was. You know, if I knew you folks were going to show up, we would have planned a show. I'm sorry. Let me try and put this in perspective for you, what 10 years means. If our television show, we've been on the air since February 1982. If our show was a New York City taxi cab, it would be getting very close to the time to inspect the brakes. But it's not. That's how long. Ladies and gentlemen, here's good news. We're a month into 1992, and so far, no Kennedys have been arrested. I think that's an excellent sign. I think it could be a great year for us. You know, in 10 years here in New York City, it's sad, but it's true. I've seen, I've seen fights. I've seen fist fights. I've seen knife fights. And I've also seen gunplay. And that's just at the Today Show. So what the heck can you do? You know, I think we have a very nice program for you this evening. Please now say hello to my good friend, Paul Schaefer. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you very much. You know, we've got a fabulous band you're going to be listening to tonight. We got a number which is sort of special that you're going to hear later, and I can hardly wait.
Thanks for everything. Thank you very much, Paul Schaefer. You know, ladies and gentlemen, in the 10 years that we've been on the air, I'll bet we've had over 100 guests. You know, actually, I'll bet you we've had over 500 guests, and it could be even more than 500 guests. It's just that nobody really wanted to do the math on this one. But the point is, we could not do this show night in and night out without guests. So here now, please enjoy an assortment of some of those fine folks who have been on our show.
I happen to be in town over doing some stuff for the NBC affiliate.
That's right.
And, you know, Ed McMahon, our good friend, could not be here.
Yeah.
But it seems, David, that you are the $1 million winner.
Oh, my God! I've won $1 million!
This is my 13th appearance, and I realize that you and I have never hugged publicly.
Never, wait a minute. Never hugged, period.
I know.
Public.
Let's
just go ahead.
No, no.
Are you? Oh, you? Okay. Sorry.
So let this be the start of something big, can we?
All right. Sure. How long have you guys been working together?
16 years.
This is sort of a virgin experience because I've never done a talk show before.
Oh, really?
So, yeah. But. Made me nervous. Could I say the word virgin? Yeah. Could I not? I didn't know.
Well, but this is going to be the greatest experience of your life. So, Phil, before you leave, I understand Oprah Winfrey makes $35 million a year. As far as Madonna goes, have you seen her lately? Do you have a friendly relationship with her now? Or?
Well, I'll tell you a secret. The fact of the matter is, as I was talking about before, things being blown out of proportion. That was all a rumor. She and I never met.
There you go.
All
right, take these off me, Sally. Take this one off here, too.
Really?
Well, yeah, really.
But it looks really good.
Yeah, okay. What did you get for your movie?
What is it to you?
My very first job was for Marshall Fields. They wanted me to do this bra ad.
All right.
I was lucky enough to, at 16, to already have something to put in it. So,
Paul, are you all right?
I just lost my footing.
Okay? And the baby's aunt is Shirley MacLaine.
True.
Wow.
Yes. This is someone you have a relationship with.
I like Shirley. She was on the program once.
I read that.
Yeah. Oh, yes. It made all the papers. Sort of
are
defending
you interested in your past lives? Do you want to talk about that?
The only thing, as far as past lives go, I vaguely have a feeling that at one point I delivered a pizza to the Eisenhowers. I know you. You're married to Geraldo.
Oh!
You have to be very, you're saying, very careful with it?
Yeah, because if you push too hard, it'll be too thick, and if you push too thin...
These things are very, very sharp.
Yeah.
You have to be.
Like razor sharp.
Oh, jeez! Oh! God, I took it off!
Okay.
Wait, who are you?
No, he's...
Get name tags. Let me know that they're
he's
with
you. He's a
buttered
specialist.
Okay, so... Who is that? Whoa!
No, wait, stop it. Okay, now...
This looks like a real bad episode of Green Acres.
Don't stand...
Is that your nose, or are you eating a banana?
Now, the thing is, don't handle it too much.
All right.
Just break off 12 ounces, Dave. Go
right.
for it.
Don't overhandle the meat.
Absolutely. The first and most important rule, do not overhandle the meat. It's true. Because what happens is... What happens...
I know. You're dying for a Pee Wee Herman joke.
I was feeling kind of nauseous.
You were actually not feeling well at all. Yeah.
In fact, I have a clip from that. I'd like to show that. Hal, could you roll that clip, please?
God. Look at this. See, when you see this tonight, you're really going to be embarrassed.
Hi.
Your ass is hanging out. You don't...
You know what?
Oh, no. God. Here, for God's sake. Here. Cover yourself up.
Life is in your hands, Doctor.
Okay. Let this disappear because it's an acid-base indicator. I have a little CO2.
For the kids back in Illinois.
Stay tuned, folks. We may be giving away a rocket. We'll be right back.
Late Night with David Letterman's 10th Anniversary Special is being brought to you by Diet Dr. Pepper and your local Dr. Pepper bottler. Diet Dr. Pepper, there's no stopping the taste. By Pontiac and your local Pontiac dealer, we build excitement. And by Budweiser, the beer with the taste as genuine as the people who drink it. Nothing beats a Bud.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time now for our 10th anniversary top 10. May I have the list, please?
Funny thing, Letterman, you got the show, but I got the babe.
That's right. Okay.
You know, it's interesting when you think about it. They're made up of essentially the same biologic material.
Isn't that odd? I have here the top 10 anniversary list. The category tonight, top 10 reasons we have been on the air for 10 years. Anton, here we go. Top 10 reasons we have been on the air for 10 years. Number 10, many Americans believe I'm filling in for Ted Koppel. Number 9, cheap to produce with illegal alien band leader. Number 8.
Hold it. What do you got there? For the record, this is my green card. I'm legal.
Okay, good. Thank you. Mix up there. Number 8, our perfect mix of comedy, music, and awkward silence. Number 7, sophisticated technology that makes home viewers think they smell bacon. I hope it's working tonight. Number 6, we were just about out of jokes after 7 years, then along came Quail. Number 5. Number 5, still have another 12 months on the hairpiece rental. Number 4. Number 4, Prozac. Number 3, it's free and it's in color. Number 2, people enjoy sitting in their underwear in front of the TV saying, "Here's your stupid Patrick Letterman." And the number 1 reason we've been on the air for 10 years, I'm Captain Dave, and America is my ship of love. You know, folks, if you think about it, the word highlights is really kind of nonspecific and vague. And for the purpose of tonight's show, that's just the way we like it. Here now are some highlights from old shows.
Finally, I found someone that helps me put oil on my body.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Because I know I have the trouble. That one spot way back down there on my back, I can never get to that.
Oh, I know. You practically have to be a contortionist to put on the oil yourself, know. You know?
It's crazy. Yeah. Okay, thank you very much, Peter. And Arnold, seriously, thank you very much. I'm sorry about the chair. They were supposed to fix it yesterday.
Welcome to New York, sometimes called Fun City. And where are you from?
From the Eastern Shore of Virginia.
Oh, do you have any questions about New York? Well, it isn't easy, that's for sure. Did you have a snack on the way? Well, won't you please?
Oh my God, whoa. Now just go in there and oh, you've got your... Come on, go in there.
I hate you! Why am I doing this?
What's wrong with the coloring? What rule do we violate here?
Well, it doesn't have any white in it.
Huh? Well, neither does the NBA.
We know very little about Alan Alda, a guy who likes Chinese food. And that's why we're here at the Hunan Park restaurant. What kind of food does he enjoy?
He likes string beans, and he likes cold noodle with a sesame sauce, fried dumpling. Most food we have, he likes it very much.
I could have sued you for everything you're worth. Well, and I didn't, because I'm not that kind of a guy.
Yeah. You know what?
What kind of a guy are you?
Not the kind of guy you're.
Obviously, over here. We're going to pause here for station identification and get the hoses out here.
And
And just a reminder for you folks who remember a couple of years ago when we would crush stuff with that enormous steamroller, later in the program tonight we'll actually be smashing items with two giant hammers. Just bang.
Boy, like that should be fun, Dave.
Oh, yeah, yeah, they're incredible. Good. They're enormous hammers.
Did he say it's time to cut the giant hammers?
Yeah, I think so. I've been fine.
Down in it. Go ahead.
You know, and so I was like, you know, trying to figure this thing out. I was like talking about this joke and everything, and I couldn't figure it out or anything, what was going on or anything. So this guy's right on my butt.
Yeah.
Okay, so,
yes? Sandy, why don't you go get your chair down
here? Oh! Oh.
Now, offer your hand to Sandy.
Oh.
Offer your hand to the lady like a gentleman.
Hey. Oh. She's...
She's gonna leap at me and pull a vein out of my neck and kill me. Maybe you'll get some, maybe you won't. Oh,
jeez!
Well, stand here. That's right. Pour a little bit in Sandy's glass quietly. Pour it.
Oh.
Thank you. All right. Folks, before we go any farther, I want to thank everybody very, very much for waiting in line here this afternoon. Thank you. And for some reason, when I said that, I felt a little like Wilt Chamberlain. You know, he's probably... Oh, thank you. Thank you very much. You know, in February of 1982, our first guest on our very first program was Bill Murray. Here now is what he looked like 10 years ago. Watch this.
You gotta know that you're bringing out the animal in me. Let's get physical, physical. I wanna get physical.
We couldn't be happier to have him back here with us tonight. Here's what he looks like now, Bill Murray. Thank you very much for being here tonight to help celebrate our 10th anniversary, and welcome to the great stage at Radio City Music Hall.
Thank you, David, and thank you, everyone. You know what Dave said about me being guest number one on the show is true, but Dave, did you know that I am also your number one fan?
No, I didn't know that. Thank you.
It's true.
That's
true.
Very nice of you to say.
I can't be more sincere.
Well, that's very sweet of you.
I have seen every show. I have the entire library on tape. I love, you know what? I love every single one of them.
Well, Bill, thank you very much. You're really being very, very kind. Thank you. I'm touched.
If there is one moment in particular that I treasure. Brought the cassette tonight. I'd love to show everybody if I could.
Sure.
This is pure gold, folks. Will you watch it and just enjoy?
Oh, huh? Thank you, Bill. All right,
you got it here.
Sure. Yeah, go ahead and roll it.
That 200 or 300 times every single time. I'm dead. I'm out on the floor. The look on his face when Paul threw the tomahawk is precious. But what a bad suit you had on.
Well,
you
looked ridiculous.
I don't know.
I was sure. That's not even me.
Fantastic, fantastic man.
Yeah. Bill, thank you very much. I appreciate you dropping by here tonight.
I did it for one reason.
Yeah.
I love you, DL.
I love you, too. Bill Murray, ladies and gentlemen. Another break. We'll be right back, folks.
Late Night with David Letterman's 10th Anniversary Special will return after these messages.
Okay, so here's what I had in mind. Get a convertible and fill it full of lovely professional models from the Elite Modeling Agency here. Take off, spend the day at the beach. What do you think? Well, we can do that swimming thing another day. Let's see if they're ready. Oh, hi. Nice to see you. Oh, goodness, how prompt. Here, let me get the door for you.
Thanks.
I thought we'd go to the beach today. Is that all right?
Perfect. Perfect.
Nice to see you. Careful getting in. Okay. Hi, how are you?
Good.
Is everyone ready?
Yep, we're ready.
Oh, good. Here we go.
It seems we stood and talked like this before. We looked at each other in the same way then. Can't we? Well, all went. The clothes you're wearing are the clothes you wore. The smile you are smiling, you smile in them. Can't remember when, oh, when. Some things that happen for the first time seem to be happening again. And so it seems that we have met before, and then we laughed before, also loved before. Well, some things that happen for the first time happening again, and so it seems that we have met before, and then we laughed before, and then we loved before.
Since 1982, we have done nearly 1,600 television shows, and in that time, we have chatted with old people, middle-aged people, and young people, and we've also talked to some really young people, and we call them kids. Now, here are a few who sneaked out of the house to be guests on our show. Hi, kids!
Hi, Dave!
It's an automatic pill dispenser, mm-hmm. and I made it for my grandmother because we thought that she was taking too much medication.
Well, that's what I thought. I think it may be true of your whole family, but it's not my place to say. Oh, so it's a timer, and it dispenses it every, like, 20 minutes, every 30 minutes. How often was Grandma taking a pill?
We're really not sure.
Yeah, well. Timothy, how old are you?
6 and a half.
6 and a half, and what grade are you in?
First.
Do you know Renee? Have you ever met her there in Brooklyn?
No.
Yeah, are you enjoying being with the other kids tonight?
Yeah.
Are you really? Do you get out of the house at all, Timothy?
I don't.
I know you don't. You're Shane Johnson, right?
Right.
Nice to see you, Shane. You're from where, sir?
Idaho Falls.
Idaho Falls, Idaho.
Yeah.
Yeah. Beautiful country there, isn't it? Yeah. Do you like living out there?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sometimes.
Sometimes, yeah. Like, and your folks, what do they do there?
Not much.
Three years old. How tall are you, Danny?
This tall.
And have you had any luck interesting toy companies in the game?
We wrote to Parker Brothers and Milton Bradley.
Well, now, what did they say?
We didn't get any response
yet.
See. If they're watching right now, please send back a response.
Am I at Amy Clark?
Yes.
And are you a Time Life operator? Did you guys get that?
Yeah.
Did you enjoy it?
Yeah.
Oh, good, okay.
This is a horn that my dad got for me when he went to Russia. He went to a special part of Russia called Georgia. They had a drinking contest. My dad won because he didn't know what they were saying, and he kept drinking and drinking. He was sick for days and days.
Hi, Lucas. Nice to see you. And you're from Golden, Colorado. Yeah, that's a great part of the world, Golden, Colorado.
We're not in Golden.
You're not in Golden.
Not Golden.
Where do you live?
That's our address.
That's your address?
Yes.
But you don't live near your address. Okay. But Golden.
Golden.
I'm sorry?
We don't live in Golden.
You don't live in Golden?
No, we don't.
No, I know you don't. You know, it's not like we're coming by or anything. Lucas, what is your invention?
Gerbil escalator exerciser.
The gerbil escalator exerciser.
And when you say the.
Hmm?
Say the.
Okay, I... The. Gee, I hope we have time for the invention. Where do you go to school, Danny?
Yes, 185.
185, and you're going to play the harmonica, aren't you? All right, go nuts. Knock everybody out. Here we go.
Come on, Hank, come on.
Get past him, Hank.
Come on.
Turn around.
Come on, Hank.
Oh!
Still a little woozy. We have to pause again. We'll be right back, folks.
We'll be right back.
Let me show you something interesting about New York City. I thought that this was just a prop for the show. I was wrong. Look, it's a studio apartment. Okay. That's about $1,800 a month right there. Folks, people and pets, you just can't beat them for real TV fun. It's the oldest law of nature. That's right, it's time for 10th anniversary stupid pet tricks. As always, this is not a competition. It's only an exhibition. Please, no wagering. Is there a Kevin Roberts here tonight? Mr. Kevin Roberts. Hi, Kevin, come on out here. Kevin, nice to see you. Welcome to the program, man. This would be your dog?
Yeah, this is Face.
Face? What kind of dog is Face?
He's an American Pit Bull Terrier.
An American Pit Bull Terrier.
Yeah.
Well, they've certainly been getting some excellent press here lately, haven't they? What will you and Face do for us this evening?
I'm going to spin him from my teeth.
You will spin the animal from your teeth using...
this.
Using your Frisbee. Do you need music? Do you need assistance? Do you need a spotter? Do you need floss? Do you need anything?
I'll get a chiropractor later. But
a drum roll, perhaps?
Drum roll, yeah.
Okay, here we go. Whoa. The dog will be... my goodness. I wish I were in his shoes. Yes, sir. Kevin Roberts. Let's take a look now at slow motion instant, the replay of the trick. Kevin Roberts and his dog. Well, very impressive. Nice to see you. Thank you for being here. Bye-bye. That's a happy-go-lucky dog, isn't it? You know, during rehearsal, the dog actually let go and landed like in the third balcony. Is there a Michael Greco with us this evening? Michael Greco. Hi, Mike. Good to see you, Michael. Here, you want me to hold that? I'll hold the milk. Yeah, thank you. And there. Oh, all right. Come on out here. And this is your dog?
Augie.
Your dog, Augie. Okay.
Augie.
And what are we going to do here?
She's gonna drink milk out of my mouth.
Hey, good. All right, I'll tell you what. Well, you lie down. Let me take Augie up here, okay?
Well, I'll need someone to hold the dog.
All right, we'll hold the dog. Paul, you hold the Augie right there. Okay. Now you lie down. Is that right?
Magic trick, Augie. Magic trick.
It's the youth of America, ladies and gentlemen. All right, now
magic trick.
Get ready, Augie. Now hold him back there. I'll load him up. All right.
Augie.
Okay, here we go. Get ready. Just pour it right in your mouth. You know, Augie, it's past the expiration date, but I'm going to pour it anyway. Okay, go ahead. Here, lay down. Okay, here we go. It's milk time. Here we go. Anton. No, do you want some milk? Go ahead. There we go. All right. Here. You tell me when. Okay, there we go. Now, bring Augie right up. Here it is. There we go. Slow motion instant replay. Nice going. Thank you very much.
You.
Goodbye, Augie. There's your dog. Thank you. Bye-bye. Oh, my. All right, are you like me? Are you sick now? Kevin DeChico. Is there a Kevin DeChico? DeChico?
DeChico.
DeChico. Hi, Kevin. Nice to see you.
Hey, nice to see
you.
Hey,
this is a very handsome-looking animal. What kind of dog is it? That's a golden retriever.
Golden retriever.
And kind of a brute. What's his name?
His name's Bud.
Bud, good dog?
Good dog.
Hi, Bud.
Nice temperament.
How old is Bud?
Bud's four.
4 years old? Nice to see you. Thanks for coming in. Excellent doggy. And you guys are going to do what here?
Bud's going to shoot baskets for the crowd yourself.
Bud will shoot baskets?
He will shoot baskets.
All right, from the regulation hoop?
Yes.
All right, what can we do? We just stand
drum
back?
Drum roll.
Okay, drum roll. And hey, Bud, if you're real good, there's some milk left over.
Yay.
Here we go. Bud shooting baskets. All
here,
right.
Buddy. Come here. Come here. Sit.
The dog's in place. Oh!
Come here.
Okay.
Higher, buddy.
All right. Just get him warmed up.
Come here.
Put him at the foul line. Higher. See what he can do there. Thank you very much. Nice to see you. Appreciate your help. Take a look at this again. That's, I'm sorry. This has got to be better than L.A. Law. Is there a Candy Stimson here this evening? Candy, come on out. There she is. Nice to see you, Candy. Candy Stimson, ladies and gentlemen. Hi, Candy. Good to have you with us. Thank you very much for being here. And this is your pet. This is your doggy...
Daffy.
Doggy Daffy.
Daffy.
Hi, Daffy. Nice to see you. Daffy is a what now?
Boston Terrier.
A Boston Terrier. And a good pet?
Excellent.
They're kind of high-strung. Do they drive you nuts?
There's days.
Yeah. Has the dog ever enjoyed a beverage out of your mouth? What are you and Daffy going to do here?
She likes to attack vacuum cleaners.
All right. I've seen this, ladies and gentlemen, get really close to the set. Here we go. Daffy attacking a vacuum cleaner. And a drum roll, or what do you want?
That'd be great.
Okay, here
Let's
we go.
The vacuum. Come on.
Daffy,
hey,
the Boston
hey,
Terrier,
hurry, hurry, hurry,
attacking.
Ready?
Oh, it's in there. Oh, my God. I think it... Oh, it could be in there. It could be the vacuum. Oh, my God. Is it the vacuum? Oh, it's the vacuum cleaner! Oh! Slow motion instant replay. Bye-bye. There you go. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to see to it that the vacuum cleaner is taken out back and destroyed. There you have it. 10th anniversary stupid pet tricks.
Are you Colleen Boyle?
Yes.
Did you write this letter, Colleen?
Oh,
you have a lovely room.
Though.
You have a nice room.
You didn't go in my room.
We were in
you?
Your room. Ask me a question about your
you
room.
You didn't go in, like, and see my...
Listen, this guy right here was sitting on your bed. Ooh. Change the sheet.
Store is Just Bulbs, and that's exactly what we sell, just bulbs.
Besides bulbs, what do you have here?
Nothing.
How about shades? Could you get shades here?
No, we are Just Bulbs. If you want shades, maybe go to a place called Just Shades.
We sell nothing.
What is the name of the store?
Just Shades.
And what can you get in here?
What can you get in here? Only shades. That's why our name is Just Shades.
So that's what they're doing. They're right over there, the Primetime Today Show. And are they doing something now? Okay. See what we can do here. Go ahead, Carl. Take a look out there.
Attention. Attention, people of New York City. My name is Lawrence Grossman, the president of NBC News. This primetime program was my idea, and I'm not wearing pants.
And you are Fat Guy.
Mike, have you been driving around Southern California? Have you ever seen any other fat license plates?
No, I haven't.
We have a surprise for you. Jess, back it on in here. Pretty exciting. Mike McGarvey, Fat Guy. Jess Gonzalez, Fat Boy. Quite a moment, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Chris, now,
As I understand it, you have two cans of the same dog food, the regular and the new improved.
Right.
And you're going to tell us if there's a difference?
Right, between kennel ration and kennel ration new improved.
You're going to conduct a little test there.
And we'll see which
okay.
is better.
All right, well, we'll look forward to it. Well, those are cute doggies.
They are, aren't they?
Yeah. Are those yours?
No, they're not. Those are props. Okay, boys.
Very cute dogs. Yeah.
Dave, I think she's right. I can't tell much difference
yeah.
between
them. All right. Thanks anyway.
It's Biff. Can I speak to you a second?
Will you people leave me alone? This is an experiment, damn it. The stuff on the right side is tingling. It's tingling. Do you know what that means? It's working. That's Dave, what that means.
Dave, that's great, but you've got a show to do.
To hell with the show. This is science.
Late Night with David Letterman's 10th Anniversary Special. We return after these messages.
I want to tell you something, folks. Those instruments are rented. Ladies and gentlemen, here he is once again, my good friend, Paul Schaefer. Paul?
Thank you. Thank you, David. You know, in 10 years, Sid, Will, and Anton and I have played with some of the greatest musicians in the world. Live tonight on this stage, we got Chrissy Hynde, we got Jim Horn, we got Carol King, we got Jim Keltner, we got the J.B. Horns, Mr. Doc Severinsen, Edgar Winter, and the great Steve Vai. And here on videotape are some of our other favorites.
Is everybody ready to have some fun?
Get up and party!
We want to be a party!
All right, get on up off your ass.
I want to dedicate this to all you ladies out there.
Pretty little thing, let me light your candle, cause the mama, I'm sure what the hand and now gets around.
Baby. Sheba. Woo-hoo!
I know you're an emotional girl.
I don't know no shame of the complaint I do. See the flame.
Station. Never want to be known.
Welcome to Wildside.
I am, ooh, I'm
me good.
We took our movies with your homegirls crew, while a businessman in suits are hawking you. I'm ready, I'm willing, and I'm able to rock and roll at night.
You were always on my mind.
Come on, told Jim Redford
that I love you.
Roxanne, you don't have to put on the red light. Roxanne.
You know, we made him pay for that microphone. Joining Paul and the band now, and believe me, we're lucky to have them, are Roseanne Cash, Nancy Griffith, Emmylou Harris, Michelle Schacht, and Mavis Staples. Thank you very much for being here. Our next guest first appeared on our program March 22nd, 1984, and for all of us, that certainly was a very, very exciting night. It's a pleasure to welcome him back to the show. Here's Bob Dylan. We'll be right back.
Yeah. we get to that, I want to...
You've touched me now twice.
I know.
Hey, come on, don't touch me. Seriously.
I'm sorry. Look at this. Look, you make a lot of money here.
Don't touch me.
You don't... Oh, okay.
Just don't touch me.
What do you want to talk about?
I don't care, but touch me again.
Don't touch me anymore.
What do I treasure most in all the world? Well, after my little dogs, Chablis and Chardonnay, I cherish the memory of the many special moments from 10 years of our television show. So pull your face up real close to the screen now and get ready to weep with joy. Mike, can you do me a favor? Just switch it over and put our show on there so the city of New York can watch tonight's epic. From the Worthington News, Worthington, Ohio. We have a lovely photo there. Local man engaged. I'm telling you, folks, this must be one slick-talking Siberian husky.
Mr. Letterman is a very busy man, but we've arranged for him to personally greet Tom.
Boy, this is the greatest.
This should be him now.
Hi, Don.
All right, try one more, Meg. There you go. Gotta heave it out there.
That looks good. It looks, it's, he could. Yes, yes!
We've switched the Folgers crystals Dave ordinarily drinks with a cup of scalding hot candle wax. Let's see if Dave can tell the difference.
Well, not bad. It's pretty good, actually.
Here, let me show you why we keep things so cold here. We really like to keep it as chilly as we possibly can. Actually, right down around freezing, if that's possible. Whoa, geez, my God! Tell you what, I'll pay for your wash if you try and oversuds one of the machines. Oh, my God. Yeah! Nice going. If we ever have, trouble with a guest. In fact, here, let me just demonstrate for you how this works. You just grab it and you just, like that. One bucket, $100. And it all goes to charity. Oh, no! All right, all I have to do is sink this, you understand? And I've won 100 pigs.
Get him, Dave!
Thank you very much, sir. Find out who this guy is and have him tossed out.
Yes!
This is the inexpensive protector from Life Alert.
There's someone outside my window.
It's like having policemen, firemen, and your personal physician on alert in your home.
Walk up.
Take him down to the nightly news studio. Turn loose in there. Look at those dogs.
Stand. Walk up. Stand.
Here we go. There's... Get him in the elevator.
Molly,
yeah. And don't come back! May we see your photos, please, ma'am?
Oh, no, I can't.
It's all right. It's me, Regis. Here we go, the photos.
There it is. Okay.
Let me get the wires here.
Okay. What? The wires?
Yeah. Now do me a favor.
What are you doing?
All you have to do is remember to jump.
What? When?
After I cut this cable.
Where? After you cut the what?
The cable.
Ah!
Paul? Paul? Paul, are you all right?
We have to do one more commercial. We'll be right back.
Late Night with David Letterman's 10th anniversary special has been brought to you by Bud Dry. It's dry brewed to drink light yet satisfy completely. Why ask why? It's Bud Dry. By Pontiac and your local Pontiac dealer. We build excitement. And by Diet Dr. Pepper and your local Dr. Pepper bottler. Diet Dr. Pepper, there's no stopping the taste. Stay tuned for The Tonight Show starring Johnny Carson with singer Richard Marx. Then on Late Night, lock your doors and phone your neighbors. It's Kmar, the discount magician. Wow.
You know, folks, for my money, a 10th anniversary just would not be complete without Radio City Music Hall, of course, a lobby full of sheep, and a handful of border collies. So, folks, here now is Tom Wilson and our old friends Molly, Ben, and Roy. Gentlemen, thank you very much for watching tonight. Thank you for watching for 10 years. Good night, everybody.
this is the General Electric building, and, you know, I have a little gift, and we thought, what the heck, let's just drop in and, you know, say hello, just see how it's going, and, you know, they can't object to that, can they? I'll just go on in and see what happens. Hi, how are you? I'm Dave Letterman. Nice to meet you. What is your name?
I'm going
to
ask you to turn the cameras off, please.
Okay, we just wanted to drop off this basket of fruit.
Okay. Would you cut the cameras, please?
It's a gesture of goodwill.
Will you cut the cameras, please?
We have to talk to the director right over there, Mr. Gurney.
Just, director...
And let you know how important this is for us, and it's made us very, very happy. We appreciate your patience and hanging around and all of your support. Have a nice evening. Thank you, folks.